Hi, this is Naomi with topshelfva.com. When working on videos for your channel, business, or for your clients, many times you use callouts and text to enhance your videos. Although you can choose whatever colors you want, to keep your branding or your client's branding, you may want to use the logo or website specific colors. You may also have additional video branding colors you wish to use on a consistent basis. The question becomes, how to create consistent access to those specific colors for every video you work on. Today, we're going to discuss creating a permanent color palette in Camtasia 9. Before we get started, a quick reminder. Please subscribe to the channel and make sure to turn on notifications so you know right away when a new video is loaded. Now, a quick note. You don't have to worry if you only have Camtasia 8. You can click here for the Camtasia 8 version or on the link in the description below titled Camtasia Training, How to Set a Permanent Color Palette in Camtasia. That will show you exactly how to create a permanent color palette in Camtasia 8. Now, for those who have upgraded to Camtasia 9, here's the problem. There's no longer a way to set a permanent color palette in Camtasia 9. No worries. I have a great workaround, and once you create a permanent color palette, you'll not have to worry about it again. It will be at your fingertips whenever you need it. Now, you will need another piece of software where you can initially design the palette. Whether that is PowerPoint, Photoshop, Gimp, Canva, Affinity, or any of the others. We'll use PowerPoint for this demonstration since almost everyone has it, and the steps I'll show you are essentially the same in any of the other programs. Let's first open a new document in PowerPoint and select a blank layout. Let's save the file first. Remember the golden rule, save, save, save. I have a folder for all my custom created callouts that I may use in more than one video, so we'll save it there. Let's call it Branding Colors Palette. Now let's grab the logo from our website using the Snipping Tool on the PC, which I have pinned to my taskbar. If you're a Mac user, you can use an equivalent tool. I just don't know what it is since I'm a PC user. If you're on a PC and don't know where the Snipping Tool is, simply type in Snipping Tool in the search window, right-click on it from the pop-up window, and select Pin to Taskbar. What I'll do is grab the logo and some of the main colors from my website. Of course, you're doing this with your own website or logo. I can close out of the Snipping Tool as it will keep what I last snipped in its memory. Then I'll go back to PowerPoint and paste it to the page using Ctrl plus V for the keyboard shortcut, or if you prefer, click on the paste icon and move the clip to a bottom corner. A quick note here, you could use the clip as your color palette as it has all the colors of your logo and your website. However, when doing videos, you will find you have other colors you want to use. You can use this one setup to create multiple palettes once you have an original color palette set. Now we are going to create several squares to create our palette. Let's create the first one. Let's select the rectangle from the drawing section and holding our shift key down, create a perfect square. Now click on Format in the drop-down arrow beside Shape Fill and select Eyedropper. Then click on the first main color from your logo that you want to have as your branding base color. And you will see the square change to the color you selected. We don't need the border around the square, so click on the drop-down arrow beside Shape Outline and select No Outline. Copy the square using your keyboard shortcut, Ctrl plus C, then Ctrl plus V to paste. Repeat this process until you have at least 12 squares to make a large palette. Line the squares up with 6 squares on the top row and 6 on the bottom row. Now, we're going to use a website that will help us select additional colors for our palette, color.adobe.com. We are going to change this center square with a white arrow to our main color. To do this, click on the first square in PowerPoint, right-click on it, then select Shape Fill, then click on More Fill Colors. This shows you the RGB numbers of your main base color. Go back to the Color Adobe page and fill in those numbers in the RGB section of the main center square. You can find various color patterns based on your main base color from analogous, monochromatic, triad, complementary, compound, and shades. I want a color darker than my main base color, so I'm going to select this dark color under shades. This shows me the RGB code of that color. I'll go back into PowerPoint and change the RGB there, and then click OK. I want to keep the main color as is, so I'll select the third square. I want this one a much lighter color than the main color. So let me go through these other choices on the Adobe Color website and see if there's one I like. Under monochromatic, I like this light blue one. So once again, I'll click on the third square of the color palette in PowerPoint and select Shape Fill. I'll then fill in the new RGB colors. Now let's do the same exact procedure for the green with the next three squares. Select the middle of the next three squares, right-click, and click on the drop-down arrow beside the Shape Fill. Then select the eyedropper. Select the green color, right-click on the square again, click on Fill and More Fill Colors to get the RGB. Back on Adobe Color, select the center square and fill in the green RGB numbers. Find a dark color you like, and back on PowerPoint, for the square to the left, fill in the RGB. Do the same for the square to the right with a lighter green. You may find a green you want to use, but want to adjust it a little. Simply add the RGB colors, then move the arrow up or down a little to get the color you want based on that green. Now do the same exact process for the purple. For the last three, I usually go back to my main color, then create brighter colors based off of that main color to round out my palette. Once you have created your palette, highlight all the squares and use your keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus G to group them together. Or you can click on Format and then on Group. Now right-click on the group and select Save as Picture. Go to the location you want to save it, which I will do in the same folder as where I have the PowerPoint saved, my Callouts folder, and give it the same name, Branding Colors Palette. Then click on Save. You can now remove your screen snippet and save your PowerPoint file. Let's move on to Camtasia 9 and set it up, so you will have the permanent color palette always available and learn how to use it for all future videos. Let's first import the color palette image into Camtasia 9. Click on Import Media, find where you saved the file, and double-click it to import it. Right-click on the image and select Add to Library. If you wanted to, you can change the name of the library asset. I'm going to move this into the folder I have set up for my company, TopShelfVA, and rename this to Branding Colors TSVA2. Whenever you want to use your color palette, you have easy access to it in your library. I've set up a simple demonstration here to show you how to use it. I'll right-click on the permanent color palette I want to use, which is the Branding Colors TSVA2, and select Add to Timeline at Playhead. Let's move this up to a corner on the canvas and minimize it slightly so it is not covering anything up. Now I'll click on this callout, and the first thing I want to do is change the background color of the callout. I'll click on the annotation properties, then click on the drop-down arrow for the fill color and select the eyedropper. I'll then select a color from the permanent color palette for the background. I don't want an outline, so I'll change this to 0. I'll then click on text properties and do the same exact thing. Clicking on the drop-down arrow of the color box, selecting the eyedropper, and then select a color from the permanent color palette. Let's say for the full video, I want a different color background than black. I can still use the permanent color palette. Click on the Canvas Options drop-down arrow and select Project Settings. Click on the drop-down arrow for the color. Using the eyedropper, select a color from the permanent color palette, then apply. Now that you are done with the permanent color palette, you can delete it from the track. If you click on the media bin, you will see the palette has been placed there for future use in the video. So if you add anything later in your video and you want to change the color, you simply add the custom color palette to your timeline and select the colors you want for the objects or text. We'll go over other ways you can use color in upcoming videos. If you have a question and would like me to create a Camtasia tutorial video for you, simply subscribe to the channel, like this video, and leave a comment below. Feel free to share this video on any of your other social media platforms and encourage your friends to subscribe to this channel. As always, this is Naomi with TopShelfVA.com. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.